I'm backing up my truck. I'm gonna hook it up. Loading up my boat with all my gear. I've been working hard all week, trying to make ends meet. Spending time wishing I was fishing. Well, Terry Wickstrom wants to take you fishing. Gather up your gear and come along. Well, Terry Wickstrom wants to take you fishing.
This is Terry Wickstrom. Join Karen Cullum, Greg Clusiau, and me as we take you to some of our favorite fishing spots from Colorado to Minnesota, the Arctic Circle to Central America and beyond. As we revisit episodes of Mountain States Fishing and Angling Adventures Television on the best of fishing with Terry Wickstrom.
All right, yeah, we were trying to get the show started here. Would you mind if we get tell the people what we're doing before you catch a fish? Oh, geez.
There we go.
Oh, no. I was switching hands and then... Wait, he's still there.
I wonder if this is going to be a good day.
They're down there,
that was
folks.
A big bite. I might have lost my minnow. I don't know yet. We're going to tell you in just a second what we're doing if we can get past... That was a big bite. That was a heavy fish. Wow. Hey. I guess we better tell you what we're doing before it gets to the point where we don't have time to talk. We're out on Leech Lake in northern Minnesota, my old stomping grounds. I actually grew up in this part of the country. Of course, you know this guy, our co-host Greg Clusiau, and you still live up here.
Yep. Still northern Minnesota. I'm all over the place.
Yeah, still going for it. And we get the pleasure today of fishing with one of the most noted and well-known famous guides in this part of the country and in the nation anymore. The notoriety is getting, you know, it's going to be time for old guys like us to ride off in the sunset pretty soon.
We're always taking over.
This is Brian Bro Brosdahl. Brian, it's going to be great to fish with you today.
Hey, thank you for having me.
And what we're going to do today, and you can correct me if I'm wrong, but we want to show you about Brian's guide service and talk to you about Leech Lake. And then we want to show you the diversity of this incredible fishery. We'll tell you more as we go, but Leech Lake is, we've seen us do a bass show on this lake before. It's one of the most world famous musky lakes ever. I mean, just incredible. It's got panfish, it's got crappies, great perch, but we're here for the walleyes today mostly, but we'll show you some of that diversity. This lake had crashed for walleyes for quite a while. Not that it didn't have them, but it was a tough fishery. And in the last couple of years, they put in a slot limit. We'll tell people more about that. But they really has come back, and now it's one of the premier walleye fisheries in the United States, certainly in Minnesota. And bro, we're gonna take some thumper jigs. We'll show them those jigs later. And
yeah, if you don't wanna drag bottom mounters or crankbaits, I got another method.
And we'll go out there and we'll show them how to pull those. So stay with us as we show you Leech Lake in northern Minnesota, one of the most diverse and probably best fisheries in the world, 110,000 acres. We won't show you the whole thing, but we'll show you enough of it to get you excited. I know it hit it so suddenly. I don't think it's real big, but it's fish.
All right, Terry.
That's a good way to start.
All right.
Need the net or not?
I don't know. I don't think it's real big, but it sure got me going. Oh, that's a little one. That's nice. Good. You ready?
That's a...
It's an eater.
That's an eater? Yep.
That's an eater.
If it's under 18, it's an eater.
Jig is out.
There you go. The board's right behind you.
Yeah, I think that would make it if a guy was to keep fish. 16. Nice eater.
This is one we can keep and eat here, but I don't think we're going to do any today.
No.
So let's get it back down in there. And we're on our way.
All right.
Way to go.
I'll tell you, one of the most surprising things about today is when we planned this trip, we're out here, it's September 13th. We expected to be into the deep fall walleye bite.
Yeah.
We expected maybe 60 degree weather and maybe 60 or below water temperatures and hoping we weren't gonna get rained on. It's 80 degrees, it's been 80 degrees for a few days, the water is 70 degrees, so folks, this is not a typical September bite. We may have to work a little bit, but there'll be fish here, but what a beautiful day to be out.
I mean, oh, absolutely.
It's like a midsummer day in Minnesota.
Yeah, this is our normally we would be having more frost, and this is hunting season and fall walleye bite. We're fishing them like it's a hot summer pattern.
Yep. All right, Greg, pretty good tug.
Might be a decent one here.
Oh, they could be really big on Leech. We've had 2 over 10.
I don't think it's a monster, but it's a nice one nevertheless.
All right. It's keeping you down.
Just a nice fish.
Nice average size.
Oh, nice. All right. Oh, nice fish. Nice fish. Good, solid fish there. Here, I'll let you hold it up for the camera and get it back in the water. I'll get the jig up.
Yeah.
There you go. Wait. You got it.
Mouthing
that before.
Yep. You got that it. Was on the Blue Glow Thumper.
Yeah, the Thumper jig.
Nice
healthy fish.
Yeah, Leech they're really Lake coming walleye. Back strong.
That one's in the slot. You don't get to keep it.
That's why there's so many nice fish like this around. And it's nice to fish with Mr. Brosdahl in the summer. It's usually all winter
yeah,
stuff.
Yeah, usually it's winter stuff. Finally, we got out in the open water here.
Okay, there we go.
Feel pretty good?
All right, Terry.
Well, maybe it's bigger than I thought.
The fish got mad at you for saying it's
small. Well, that's a pretty decent fish. Don't lose that now.
No.
There we go. Awesome. All right. Good.
Nice one.
It's going to be in the slot. We're going to have to let it go, but that's okay. Nice fish. Lift up.
Leech Lake has really come back. Look at how he gulped it.
Yeah, he really took it down there.
These fish are just eating it.
My finger's by the hook, so watch.
There we go. You bet. There okay. We go.
There we go. Well, I left Minnesota 20-some years ago. I've been back, but I haven't fished Leech. And, you know, we're going to tell you later the story of how this lake has come back. This might not have been possible a couple years ago. But, boy, has it come back. It's a slot limit here. I'm sure this is within the slot. We're going to have to release it. But just a good, solid Leech Lake fish.
21-incher. We're going to let her go.
There we go.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Now, all right.
Now, bro, the slot limit. This lake, let's tell the story of what's happened on this lake. This is really a great comeback story. You know, Leech used to be one of the premier walleye lakes in Minnesota years ago. I grew up here. You heard about Leech. You know, it's known for muskies, bass, walleyes, pike. It's just an incredible fishery. But the walleyes had almost gone away as far as being consistent.
Yeah.
And a few years ago, they really made a program. They put a slot limit in to protect the fish. They started heavy stocking. What a success story.
Well, it makes a difference. Leech Lake walleyes took a beating. When slots were implemented in surrounding lakes, a lot of people came here. Cormorants came to the lake. We had 5,000 nesting pairs of cormorants. They ate a lot of the small fish. The bigger fish you see now, the real giants, they were always here. But we needed a little help, a little stocking program, and slots do work. I mean, the lake.
And they are actually reducing the cormorants too. Yeah, they're letting them.
They reduced number of cormorants. They still left some because naturally they're part of the ecology, but there was just too many at the time. So the cormorants being reduced, saving the small fish, and also a little booster stocking program, which really helped. And then slots do work. Here's the proof. There's good eaters. You keep them under 18, you could eat those. And if you want a trophy, it's got to be over 26.
Well, you know, and the other great thing about this fishery, they're comparing it to Mille Lacs right now.
Yeah.
It's come back so great.
That's great, and Mille Lacs is a tremendous
walleye
fishery.
Factory.
Yeah. You don't get the fish all the time, so I don't always...
want the guide to catch one.
I hardly ever...
Ooh, it's got some bend in that rod.
Yeah, this is actually fun today. I get to actually fish.
Oh, I tell you what, I love... You know, today's weather doesn't make it for the most steady fishing, but September to have this kind of weather and to be this kind of...
Just another nice Leech Lake walleye.
Yep.
Look at that. Oh, that looks like about a 20-incher here.
Yeah. Oh, I went I went under him.
There you go.
Terrible net job. I didn't want anybody else to catch a fish but me, so I was going to try to shake him off the net. That's bigger than I thought.
Yeah,
that's a nice fish. Oh, hold still. Get you here so we don't tangle you up.
He thumped the thumper. All right, we'll get this one back here.
Put that hook in me. Okay. Boy, I can't believe that. I usually net fish pretty good. That was terrible.
There you go, buddy.
That was about the worst job of netting I've ever done in my life.
That happens. It's not fun until something like that happens.
You know, bro, we're out here walleye fishing. But I think people who've seen you in the magazines and stuff probably think you're more famous for your ice fishing and some of your pan fishing. But you do guide for all of that.
Oh, yeah. Actually, in the summertime, I'm walleyes. And in the wintertime, I guide for perch.
Perch.
Yep. Yeah. And the reason being is for the action. Walleyes. Except for lakes like Lake of the Woods, which is really darkly stained, and Red Lake. A lot of my glacial lake areas here that I guide on, it's a morning-evening thing for walleyes. So I just strictly went for jumbo perch, and I stay busy that way.
Well, you know, you've been seeing us out here in the open water today, but Bro is actually probably one of the most famous ice fishermen in the United States. I mean, that's probably how we got to know each other, you and I and Greg, was through the ice fishing, all the different means and people we did in the ice shows and stuff, and that's probably how we got to know each other.
Well, yeah, I met you at ICAST. I was there for my sponsors.
If people want to come out and do some ice fishing with you, when are the times of the year?
For ice fishing, February and March, and they fill fast, so book early. I only have so many dates available because I also do seminars and shows for ice fishing, so I share that with my guiding in the wintertime. Where in the summertime, I still do some seminars and shows, but I'm 99% guiding all summer long.
So if somebody wants to book a summer trip, they should still book ahead, but there's more open dates, but ice fishing. And if you want to learn about ice fishing, get out and catch those panfish, perch mostly, and just have a blast. Get a hold of this guy. We'll put the information up again and then again at the end of the show. And I think I'm getting bit here, so let's see what's going on.
There we go.
It was just a weed. A little bit of a breeze and it's picking up.
Boy, the lake was flat today. I've been a while since I've seen a calm like that.
Well, I tell you what, it's got a little bend in the rod. That's a little better fish, I think.
Yeah, there it is.
Oh yeah, this is a nicer fish, nicer fish.
Wow. There's a good old Leech Lake walleye. I love it. These things are a blast.
Oh, it's just so much fun.
Ooh, he's not done yet.
No, he's not. And I'm going to be more careful this time. God. Do it right. After all the tournaments I've been in and times in the PWT championships netting, I'd be a little better with a net. I usually am pretty good. Nice walleye. Great. That may be the best fish. That may be the second best fish of the day.
Yeah, I think yours still wins.
You know, even if it didn't, mine's not here, so I can say it was. That's definitely a slot fish. These are the healthy fish. Folks, I'll tell you what, these fish aren't just biting it when they bite it. They're inhaling it. Nice, nice walleye.
Wow. Here, I can get the hook out.
All right,
I'm going to do is, I'm going to go through the gill without touching his gills.
Right, and that's a great trick to show people when a fish is hooked deep like that. If you do it right, then you just clip it off.
I'll just clip it off real quick so I don't want to injure the fish.
It comes through like that. Nice, nice walleye. Nice Leech Lake walleye. Awesome. Awesome.
Beautiful fish, huh?
Oh, it's great. Let me take this one back. This was one of our TV fish that we got to let go. She's probably a she this size, I would think, bro.
There are some big males. We've got 27-inch males out here.
We want to thank you for posing for TV with us.
Thank you for the fight. That was a fun fight.
They do fight hard.
Oh,
there she
yeah.
goes. I can see her kicking away. Leech Lake walleyes.
Yeah, that was fun, huh?
Oh, awesome. I tell you what, you know, the one thing people are going to complain sometimes is we've caught a lot of fish today, but we haven't caught any we could eat. We've caught one that was an eater size. We've caught all big ones. We're catching all big fish. It's just something you have to suffer with sometimes when you come to a fishery like this.
Yeah, some days you just pound them, and a lot of them go back there in the slot, but you know, most of the time we catch fish to eat.
Oh, yeah.
There's rarely a day you don't get your limit. But I'm not going to say I guarantee the limit every time because we catch a ton of fish. I've had 50 fish days for 4 hours, and then I've had 25 8-hour days. So it's hard to say what's going to happen. It's different every day. I've had flat calm days where the fish just go nuts when they're chasing the bait fish. Like today, they're moving up.
Yeah.
We got a little ripple now. but we still caught them when it was flat.
Yeah, we've struggled a little bit today. We're not going to kid anybody. It it's September, middle of September. It should be about 60 degrees with a breeze going across. It's been 80 degrees dead calm, so it hasn't been exactly ideal. But we're catching fish, and we expect with the breeze coming up for it to really take off and get even better yet before we're done.
It's time now for Greg's Tackle Tip of the Week.
Okay, bro, what's our presentation for today? What are we going to use?
We're going to use the thumper jig. It's got a spinner built in right at the bottom. It's also got a barbed wire bait saver, so when you put a minnow on there, it stays on there. And we've been using live bait on a thumper head. You can get these with little twister style tails, curl style tails. But I like to use live bait on these. They're a great bait delivery system. This time of year when people are using bottom bouncers and crankbaits, a lot of my customers don't like to sit and hold a bottom bouncer rod or drag crankbaits in the rod holders. They want to hold the rod.
They like to be doing stuff.
They want to do something. And it's a combination of jig and spinner. And you control these, you can cast them. We use them a lot all summer long.
Well, you've got vibration, flash, color. Mm-hmm. And you put the minnow on there, you got meat on there, you got scent, you have it all.
And we've used crawlers on these. You could use a half a crawler, or what I like to do is take a smaller crawler and fold it on and put it in half. A lot of people are dragging them on two hooks straight. Well, I'm a firm believer that walleyes don't know what a night crawler looks like. I fold it in half because a lot of these fish are feeding on crayfish. And I like to make the two pinchers. So you fold it in half, I hook it through the round part. So it's like that. But I go through one more time on both sides. And then you shove it up on that bait keeper. And that's what you use. Now, this is a big crawler for this one, but that's just so you can see it.
And it's brown like a crayfish.
Brown.
It's got the two arms like a crayfish.
And it's got the spinner for flash in the water. But it also, it gives a little vibration, and the fish can sense it. When it goes by, they pick it up, they chase it, and when they get close, they'll grab it. But another thing I always do with my crawlers before I put them in, I ruin them. I snip at least one of the tips off. More of a scent trail.
Okay.
That was Greg's Tackle Tip for this week, and now back to more angling adventures.
All right, the camera boat's hooked up. That's Steve Pemble, our camera boat driver today. He's letting him fish a little bit in the front of the boat. And
we just gave him a thumper jig.
Him a thumper jig, and it looks like he's about to land. He may get the fish. Oh, it's going to be the fish of the day in the camera boat.
Oh my lord.
Yes, it is.
Whoa, Steve. Make sure we get good camera shots of that. You know, some guys, we took him, he's been our camera guy before and stuff. We took him to Red Lake in the winter just to let him fish.
Yeah.
And he stole the show. So now we bring him out here. He's the camera boat driver.
Wow.
He's the camera boat driver. He forgets, you know, Steve, I'm a big star. Do you need me to come over there and hold that fish?
I think I got it.
Okay. Way to go. Steve Pemble, the camera driver. All right, Steve.
Nice fish.
Steve Pemble, the camera operator. All right, get that back in the water so people don't know that you caught it.
All right, Steve.
All right, good job.
Good job.
Nice fish.
Yes, sir, nice fish. Nice Leech Lake walleye caught on a Northland thumper jig. You know, whether I'm fishing a river in Colorado or the flats off the Florida Keys, one of my most important accessories are my HaveRevision polarized sunglasses. Not only do they allow me to see into the water, see the fish, but they protect my eyes from the intense UV. HaveRevision makes great high-end polarized sunglasses for men and women, and you can avoid the typical retail markup for high-end glasses by logging on to HaveRevision.com and using the member code FISHTECH.
Oh, there we go.
All right.
Oh, another one. This one feels like it might be a keeper.
You're turning on now.
Yeah.
I got ahead of you, but you're just wiping me out.
Oh, it's a little bit too big for our slot.
Nice fish. Nice health. You know what? They're so fun to catch. Nice, healthy fish.
It's rare that I get to fish. On the guide trips, I usually don't fish.
Lift it. Well, you didn't lift them. Well, bring them in. Here we go.
There we go. All right.
I didn't want to knock them off. That's close to a slot fish.
Yeah. It might be over still.
It's going to be probably a little long. You know, it's a little skinnier than some of the others.
Yeah.
It's a nice fish, but...
Look at that bloodsucker on it. It's been inactive.
Yeah, it's been just sitting down there on the bottom.
When they get them bloodsuckers like that... There we go. I can hold that.
That means they're just sitting down in that mud. Nice healthy. It is a nice healthy fish. Look at that jig just pop them right there. Northland thumper jigs. That's close, bro.
Yeah, that's close, but it's still over.
So close.
Nice fish.
Close, but no dinner yet. We keep catching too big a fish.
Don't panic. There's restaurants in town.
I tell you what. We're out on Leech Lake. We're catching walleyes. We're having a good time. It's August weather. Let's get this back in the lake. Hey guys, come on over here a second. We're out here, we're catching walleyes, we're under after everyone. Leech Lake with Brian, Brosdahl. I'll say his name wrong if I don't do it right.
Yeah.
Look it up, and we're gonna put all the information up here. And of course, you know this guy, Greg Clusiau, he's on the show all the time, our co-host. We're gonna keep fishing, but it's time for you guys to go on to the next show. So we're gonna keep, but if you wanna come down, catch multiple species, have a great time, catch walleyes from what size and what numbers?
Oh, anywhere from 14 to 31 inch, and some days we get 25, other days even 75 are probably my best days.
Get a hold of Bro, the information will be here. Join us next week on Angling Adventures.